Now we present filmed highlights of the 1954 Stanley Cup Finals, the World Series of Hockey. Detroit Red Wings, winners over Toronto in the semifinals, cross sticks with their close rivals in the regulation season, the Montreal Canadiens, who breeze through in four straight over Boston. The series opened at Olympia in Detroit on the night of April the 1st. The Rocket, Maurice Richard, gets the first good shot of the series. Midway in the period, Dickie Moore is detected hooking Marcel Pronovo behind the Detroit net and goes off with a penalty. The power play quickly results in a Detroit goal. Ted Lindsay deflects Dutch rival shot and the Wings lead 1-0. Time 13 minutes 44 seconds. Late in the period, Lindsay is penalized, but he soon has company in the penalty box, Maurice Richard. And when the Rocket explodes in vigorous protest, referee Bill Chadwick adds a misconduct, and it takes teammate Tom Johnson to restrain Richard as he seeks to get at the referee. In the second period, Tom Johnson hauls down Tony Leswick and gets a penalty. Tony really slides along to make sure the referee sees it. The power play fails to increase the wing margin, although Delvecchio, Dineen, and Rybal all have good shots. Red Kelly passes out to Rybal for his try. Boom Boom Jeffrion ties the score while Glenn Scove is serving a penalty midway in the second period. Dickie Moore, number 12, can't resist the temptation to give Terry Sawchuk a parting taunt as the light blinks. Red Kelly is roughly treated behind the goal, and Lorne Davis gets a shot from Montreal. Now here's a good example of Sawchuk's crouching style as he peers through the player's legs to avoid being screened. Lorne Davis bangs into Benny Boyd, and Sawchuk uses his big stick like a tennis racket to clear the puck. Dutch Rybal scores for the Wings. They're ahead 2-1. This was on a power play while Dallard St. Laurent was serving a penalty. The time, 1:52 of the third period. St. Laurent came out of the penalty box to take a pass from Olmstead. He has only the goalie to beat, but Terry makes a sensational save. Dickie Moore makes a real try for an evener on a close-range backhander. Red Kelly has a chance to sew it up, but Jacques Plante robs him. Kelly is in position again. This time he makes no mistake, lifting an angle shot over Plante's body into the net, making the final score of the first game, Detroit 3, Montreal 1. Game 2, also played at Olympia, was practically decided during 56 fatal seconds in the first period. Dickie Moore scored while the Wings were two men short, Gordie Howe and Tony Leswick both sitting out penalties. Terry Sawchuk protested, Bernie Jeffrion interfered. 15 seconds later, Maurice Richard golfed in the second goal, his first score of the playoffs, and Canadiens now led 2-0. 31 seconds later, with the Wings still one man short, the Rockets scored again, completing a three-goal spree within just 56 seconds. Captain Ted tries to get his team back into contention on a play with Red Kelly. But goalie Plante blocks his shot, and Dutch Rybal also fails on the rebound. In the second period, Marty Pavlich scoops a loose puck just wide of an open corner. He's hustled into the boards by Bud McPherson. The player is penalized by the referee. Alex Delvecchio was credited with an unassisted goal when Butch Bouchard cleared the puck into his own net during the power play. Trailing 3-1, the Wings try a comeback rally. Gordie Howe, Red Kelly, and Benny White all fire hard shots at Plante's goal. Tempers flare in a roughhouse, but no penalties are called. Bert Olmstead's shot dribbles through to Sawchuk, who covers with a dive. The Wings fail to clear successfully, and Floyd Curry drills a hard shot from the right wing. Leswick shoots. Marty Pavlich fires from the left boards. Glenn Scove is tripped by Butch Bouchard. No penalty is called. The end seems inevitable. Canadiens win 3-1. The series is deadlocked, one game apiece. The scene of action is now the Forum in Montreal. The Red Wings are in dark uniforms. Floyd Curry is denied a goal by Terry Sawchuk's fine save, and the Wings click on their first try. Alex Delvecchio scores on a pass from Gordie Howe. Time elapsed only 42 seconds. Another Montreal defenseman, Tom Johnson, stages a thrilling rush. And Eddie Mazur makes Terry Sawchuk move smartly for his bullet drive from close range. The Rocket is penalized and shows his displeasure by whacking the ice with his stick. Ted Lindsay, Gordie Howe, and Alex Delvecchio spearhead the wing power play, but they fail to add to the 1-0 lead. With a few seconds remaining of his sentence, the Rocket tries to ease over the boards, but referee Chadwick forces him to sit down. When released, the fiery Rocket zooms up the ice and nearly scores. A pileup at the Montreal goal, and then Ted Lindsay scores a second Red Wing goal with 3 minutes to go in the first period. Johnny Wilson makes it 3-0 early in the second period, right after a face-off at the Montreal blue line. Here's some rough-and-tumble action behind the Detroit net. And seconds later at the other end, Alex Delvecchio circles the goal to pass out for Gordie Howe. Glenn Scove rams into goalie Jacques Plante. For Montreal, Ken Mosdell is wide of the target. Lorne Davis rides Ted Lindsay into the boards, but the wing captain is still able to center out for Dutch rival. Third period action. Terry Sawchuk doesn't like to be crowded. He clips Tom Johnson. The Montreal player was guilty of elbowing, and both drew penalties. The Rocket on a speedy rush. Tom Johnson catches the Wings out of position during a power play. Scores for Canadiens. Bernie Jeffrion was serving a penalty. Johnson broke into the clear, and the score is now 3-1. Metro Prestai scored 40 seconds later, jamming the puck home after coming around from behind the cage. The Wings now lead 4-1. Gordie Howe, sizzling 30-footer, eluded Plante's grasp with 3.5 minutes to go. The Wings are ahead 5-1. Dollard Saint-Laurent sped in to beat Sawchuk 5 minutes to go. That made the final score of Game 3, Detroit 5, Montreal 2, giving the Wings the edge in the series again, 2-1. Game 4 was also played at the Forum in Montreal. Gordie Howe tries to give the Wings another quick lead. Saint-Laurent carries right into the goal mouth, and in the scramble, Floyd Curry also has a good chance to score, but Sawchuk is on guard. Alex Delvecchio is hooked by Bert Olmsted, and referee Red Story penalizes the Montreal player. The power play almost backfires as Ken Mosdell breaks away. Watch Sawchuk look around to see if the puck has reached the net. Best chance in the power play came when Red Kelly kicked the puck out to Jimmy Peters. Bernie Jeffrion is on the wrong wing for this try, and Canadiens learn wing defensemen can hand out checks. Benny White floors Jeffrion. Kelly takes care of Richard. Watch on the next shot by Johnny Wilson how goalie Plante muffs the disc, and as it dribbles past him into the goal, he looks at his glove as if it might have a hole. Wilson has given the Wings a 1-0 lead at the 2:09 mark of the second period. Another general outbreak, which doesn't seem to call for penalties from the referee. Dickie Moore tries to power in the puck in a goal mouth scramble. Third period, Detroit still leading 1-0. After Johnny Wilson's shot, both Bill Dineen and Bob Golden dash in for the rebound. Alex Delvecchio makes Plante hit the ice. Tom Johnson misses a great chance on Bert Olmsted's pass out. Alex Delvecchio is pulled down by Doug Harvey, but no penalty is called. On this play, Marty Pavlich misses by inches. His shot bounces off the goalpost. Dollard St. Laurent tries splitting the defense. Sawchuk steps up to clear the loose puck. After a face-off, Mitro Prestai gets a shot, and he digs the puck out of the corner to Johnny Wilson for another. In the final minute, Jacques Plante is taken off the ice. Montreal attacks with six men, leaving their goal unguarded. Jean Beliveau gets a great chance from right in front, and then Red Kelly lifts the puck from inside his own blue line. It rolls into the open net, turns on the light, and Detroit leads 2-0. It was scored with 7 seconds to play and sewed up the game. So the Wings congratulate Sawchuk on the shutout. Detroit now leads in the series 3-1. An overnight train ride and the teams are back at Olympia, Detroit. Jerry McNeil, now the Montreal goalie. Ken Marsdell leads the Canadian attack early in the game. And Bert Olmsted also gets in a couple of good shots in this flurry. Ted Lindsay gets some rough treatment from Tom Johnson in the corner. Johnny Wilson's shot has Jerry McNeil lying across the goal mouth. Gordie Howe takes a pass from Ted Lindsay, drills a hard shot, and Jimmy Peters almost converts the rebound. On a power play, Harvey wraps his arms around Howe, and Richard upsets Peters. Dickie Moore and Marty Pavlich bang into each other at the boards, and a three-ring battle breaks out. Watch little Tony Leswick take on giant Jean Beliveau. Then Red Kelly and Butch Bouchard square off. Four players, Pavlich and Leswick of Detroit, Johnson and Beliveau of Montreal, all get penalties. Just as the period ends, Leswick is tripped by Doug Harvey, but there's no penalty this time. In the second period, Gordie Howe tests McNeil, playing his first game in 2 months. Doug Harvey slides into the board. And watch Glenn Scove's goal that was disallowed. Referee Chadwick ruling he kicked it in. Did you notice how Scove was pushed and held by Dollard St. Laurent, number 19? In the third period, Lorne Davis gets in close for a shot from the left side. Doug Harvey takes another tumble, upset by Mitro Prestai. And watch now as Alex Delvecchio is the victim of Tom Johnson's vicious slash. Alex crumbles to the ice, and his teammates surround him. Trainer Carl Mattson comes out to render treatment. Alex recovers quickly. He's soon back in action. Johnson was penalized, and on the power play, Gordie Howe gets a pat out, but he's too closely guarded to get a shot. Bill Dineen takes a whack at the puck in a scramble. While Howe himself is serving a penalty, Montreal's twin bombers from right wing, Richard and Geoffrion, make things hot for the wing defense. Richard and Geoffrion team up again on a couple of threatening rushes. Marty Pavlich, killing off the penalty, gets a breakaway chance, but he's hauled down by Maurice Richard. At full strength again, the Wings attack, and Johnny Wilson comes close twice. Watch on Johnny's try from the goal mouth coming up. How the puck bounces to Big Butch Bouchard. He almost puts it in his own net. Bouchard's number is 3. In the overtime, here's that game-saving stop by Jerry McNeil on Gordie Howe's low drive. The series almost ended with that shot. And here's the play that prolonged the series. Kenny Marsdell backhands one, past Terry Sawchuk, actually taking the shot with his back to the net. Montreal wins 1-0 after 5 minutes 45 seconds of sudden death overtime. So it was back to the Forum at Montreal for Game 6. Detroit still leads in the series 3-2. Bernie Jeffrion gets his own rebound for a double try early in the game. Marcel Pronovost is tripped by Lauren Davis, and referee Red Story sends the Montreal player to the penalty box. Pronovost leads the power play. Gordie Howe fires a shot, and Alex Delvecchio just misses the rebound. The Wings fail to cash in their man advantage. Bob Goldham dives to block Eddie Mazur's shot for Canadiens. In the second period, the game's still a scoreless tie. Dollard Saint-Laurent drills a hard one after a face-off. Boom Boom Jeffrion speeds into ring territory. His bullet drive from 45 feet out bulges the net. This was at 12:07 of the second period and started another quick three-goal rally for Montreal. As Jeffrion scored, he was crashed to the ice, but he was soon okay. 1 minute later, Floyd Curry scored on a screenshot. Canadiens lead 2-0. And 78 seconds later, Curry scored again. Canadiens leading 3-0. The referee was flung a delayed penalty to Voit as the goal went in. Montreal had scored three quick goals within 2 minutes and 18 seconds. On this play, Glenn Scove gets pushed around by goalie Jerry McNeil and Ed Mazur, but he still sets up Tony Leswick for a goal-mouth try. Elmer Locke, who sat out the early games of the series, just misses a return pass at the goal mouth. And on the return rush, Gordie Howe is sent tumbling by Dollard Saint-Laurent. Here's an unusual goal. Red Kelly and Mitro Prestai rush for the Red Wings. Prestai takes the shot. Montreal players Tom Johnson and Gay Stewart back into the goal, upset their goalie, and all three tumble. In the tangle, the puck is carried over the line. Prestai was credited with an unassisted goal. The score now is Montreal 3, Detroit 1. The Rocket rushes, but Ed Mazur fans on his setup pass. Still in the fight, the Wings attack. But Glenn Scove's shot bounces off the post, and Tony Leswick's hits the side of the net. Seconds later, Maurice Richard settles matters by scoring to put Canadiens comfortably out in front, 4-1. That's the way the game ended, knotting up the series again, 3 games apiece, and calling for a 7th and deciding game. The contest attracted a record crowd at Olympia Friday evening, April 16th, and it was a real thriller. Early in the game, Marcel Pronovost broke through, only to be denied his goal by Jerry McNeil's great save. Ted Lindsay's slap shot on this play just went wide. Boom Boom Jeffrion unleashes that blazing shot. Pronovost on another good scoring chance. Paul Masnik gets the puck over to Floyd Curry, whose screenshot passes several players, including Terry Sawchuk. Montreal leads 1-0 at 9:17 of the first period. Pronovost in the clear again. Another great save by McNeil. Notice the referee leans into the net as the goalie arises, seeing if the puck has crossed the line. It didn't. Jimmy Peters inches wide. The Rocket is always dangerous. Dickie Moore passes to Elmer Locke, but Bob Goldham blocks and clears. Mitro Prestai is tripped by Paul Masnik at the 22nd mark of the second period, and this proved to be a very costly penalty for the Canadiens. Red Kelly started and finished the play that resulted in the tying goal. 40 at full strength, Canadiens seek to regain the lead, but Jean Beliveau couldn't reach Moore's setup pass. As they sustain the pressure, Ben White comes through with a daring dive to block Floyd Curry's shot. For the Wings, Wilson and Dineen team up on a real threat. The rookie Dineen just missed the rebound. Terry Sawchuk stretches to catch Richard Blazer. Going the other way in the third period, the Rocket threatens again. Gordie Howe drops on the puck to smother. Red Kelly's pass to Johnny Wilson is intercepted, ruining a promising play. Mitro Prestai is in the corner with Tom Johnson, and he's not polite company. Former Red Wing Gay Stewart brings Sawchuk out of the net on this rush up left wing. And now watch Bob Golden block Floyd Curry's hot shot as the third period is nearly ended. Maurice Richard loses his stick, sweeps the puck into the net with gloved hand. Coach Irvin said if Richard had left it there for Ed Mazur, 23, who was trailing, he could have scored easily. Referee Chadwick quickly waved off the goal, and the game moved into sudden death overtime. Olmstead blasts one from the blue line. Del Vecchio dumps Dickie Moore. Then Alex drills a shot after taking a pass from Ted Lindsay. Gordie Howe passes out, but Canadiens clear. Gay Stewart almost won the cup for Montreal on this run. Terry Sawchuk saving the day with this great diving save. And here comes the winning goal. Glenn Stove takes the puck over the blue line, shoots it around the boards to Tony Leswick, number 8. He shoots, he scores. At 4:29 of the overtime, the Wings win 2-1, and they have the cup. Teammates fairly mob little Tony, the little fellow who scored the year's biggest goal. Montreal players skate off sadly, without even extending the traditional hand clasp of congratulations. Jubilant Detroit fans, excited to fever pitch by the tense dramatic struggle, flood out onto the ice in mad confusion. The Stanley Cup, now the Red Wings for the 6th time. Miss Marge Norris, Red Wing president, her brother Bruce and manager Jack Adams come out to receive the cup. Miss Norris congratulates Captain Ted Lindsay. National League President Clarence Campbell pleads for quiet so he can make his speech. Miss Norris stands beside him, ready to make her acceptance remarks. Bruce Norris makes the circuit of the masked Red Wing players with individual congratulations. Press photographers are having a field day. They line up the wings behind the cup, and flash bulbs really pop. Jack Adams, Miss Norris, and President Campbell all pose. Miss Norris is the first woman to get her name on the Stanley Cup. Radio announcers interview players on the ice. Marcel Pronovo is at the French broadcast microphone. And some confident and enterprising youngsters sum up the happy scene at the...